Greetings from Indian Medical Association and Heart Care Foundation of India. मैं हूं डॉक्टर के अग्रवाल, नेशनल प्रेसिडेंट. मेरे साथ में है डॉक्टर एन वी कामत, जो कि प्रिंसिपल एडवाइजर हैं इंडियन मेडिकल एसोसिएशन के. और साथ में मेरे साथ में है मेजर डॉक्टर प्राची गर्ग, जो कि मेडिकल डायरेक्टर है हार्ट केयर फाउंडेशन ऑफ इंडिया के. हमारा टॉपिक पिछले हफ्ते हमने लिया था अफोर्डेबल हेल्थ केयर, कि एक आदमी अपनी रीच के अनुसार में कहाँ जाए. उसी चैप्टर को हम कंटिन्यू कर रहे हैं. लास्ट टाइम में हमने बात करी थी कि हर आदमी को, हर इंसान को एक हक है, एक उसका राइट है. सो एवरीबॉडी हैज अ राइट टू गेट अफोर्डेबल हेल्थ केयर. एंड वी हैव सजेस्टेड अ फॉर्मूला दैट दे कैन बी प्राइवेट पेशेंट्स, दे कैन बी सेमी प्राइवेट पेशेंट्स, दे कैन बी जनरल पेशेंट्स, एंड दे कैन बी इकोनॉमिकली वीकर सेक्शन पेशेंट्स. पेशेंट्स हु आर इकोनॉमिकली वीकर सेक्शन ऑफ द सोसाइटी, दे शुड गेट फ्री ट्रीटमेंट, रेफर टू वेरियस स्कीम्स ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट. You have, every state has schemes, every government hospital has a place for them, and definition is anybody whose family income is less than 3 lakhs. Private patients are the ones who want a luxurious treatment, who wants a private room, a single, they don't want to share anything, any information, any facility. That care is 100% care. And there will always be super deluxe patients who want more than that, where the charges can be decided by the patient and the doctor. But 100% payment is private. Semi-private means 75% of the payment. These are the people who, wherever they go, they should share a room. In 2 patients one room, 3 patients in one room, 4 patients in one room. So they should share their facilities. That means 2, 3, or 4 patients are sharing the same bathroom and the same facility. So these are, and the same TV. So these are the shared room, and they should be able to pay 75% of the total charges. And then there will be economy ward, like a ward. It's like a, where there may be 15, 10, 15 or 20 patients in a ward, and they share a common facility. They should be able to get a service at 50% of total cost. That is, if the treatment is 1 lakh, their bill should be 50,000. And those who are sharing, if the bill is 1 lakh, their bill should be 75,000. And those who are economically weaker section of the society with a family income of less than 3 lakhs, these are the people who should get subsidy at every level. In government hospitals, they are free, and they should get an entitlement that if they get treatment in the private sector, they should bring a letter from the government, and the government should be able to reimburse them depending upon their powers. Similarly, in terms of insurance, same things will come. Depending upon the entitlement of the insurance, their charges should be the same. Now, this is what we had discussed as a last time. Last time we had discussed many modules, but this is the module which has ultimately been finalized. A private, semi-private, economy, and economic EWS category. These are the 4 categories under which every patient should be classified, so he knows that I am a general ward patient wherever I go. That means anything of that hospital, I should get at 50%. Second thing we discussed was the concept of budget hospitals. And the conference, budget hospital means there should be centers where for semi-private, charges are only for either economy ward or a semi-private. For example, in Delhi we have a surgical center where all the surgeries are done at 10,000 rupees. That's for economically weaker section of the society. Similarly, there can be budget, like there are budget hospitals, budget hotel and budget airlines. There can also be budget hospitals where everything is, say, 75% or 50%, depending on what category of budget hospitals they are making. Let's now continue our discussion with Dr. Prachi Garg and Dr. Kamath. Dr. Kamath, take over.
Yeah, we are discussing the differential rates for the treatment in private hospital. But what is your idea of the medical insurance, the health insurance? Most of the people, they are insured.
See, the problem in India when it comes to insurance is they are not covering nobody. And 80% of the bill is in the OPD. Okay. Patient is discharged, then throughout the year, he is not getting reimbursement. So the system has to come, OPD must be covered, and co-pay must come. Patient must pay, say, 25%. That's 75% we pay by the insurance, for which we need more and more of regulations. I personally feel everybody should be insured, and a person who can't afford insurance, the government should pay, and if he is working under somebody, the employer should pay for his insurance. And the concept of monthly insurance has to come. It may not be yearly. You need to come out with a monthly insurance, but you don't have to pay the whole amount in one go.
That also covers the outpatient.
Yes, we should also cover the outpatient.
So, one of the, another important area where patient has to spend a lot of money on the drugs, on the medicines. Because they have to spend a lot of out-of-pocket expenses.
See, 80% of the payment comes from out-of-pocket expenses. And most of the people in India, they take loan to cover the cost because they can't afford that cost. Therefore, it becomes a duty of the medical profession to give them cost-effective treatment. Therefore, the cost of medicines, if we rightly speak, can be reduced by 70% if doctors hire the services of a pharmacist as a part of their practice. I personally feel every doctor must have a pharmacist, for which you charge extra 50 rupees or 100 rupees extra to cover the cost. But their job should be, they should make sure, and the concept, new concept is not MRP, the concept is PTR, price to retailers. So all those drugs where price to retailers is say 2 rupees, MRP is 10 rupees, they should be available to the patient at 3 rupees and not 10 rupees. So the doctor should know what is the price to retailer, or dispensing must come back. So that you are giving that margin. The margin of the PTR, MRP minus PTR margin should be given to the patient.
So that means actually the pharmacist, the chemist shop will have to...
See, I talk to many of the hospitals and they say that their major income is three segments. One is pharmacy, second is investigations, and the third is 25% they charge to the doctors. So this is the only income they make. And these all three are legal and unethical. So the patient must get, see, I like the concept of fair shop medicine and a fair shop investigations, which Mamata Banerjee is contemplating in West Bengal. That's a good idea. All hospitals owned by medical doctors should have a fair shop investigations and a fair shop medicine shop, where the margin should go to the patient. Doctor should charge in their consultation. Doctor consultation is very low. Why? Doctors should charge their fair consultation. They are not charging their share, and they are letting the chemist and the investigations charge overcharge. So there has to be a balance out. So the doctors can charge a fair amount of consultation, but they should make sure that the patient doesn't get fleeced month after month when they come to investigations and treatment of the drugs.
That means we need to have more counters and shops like Janaushadhi and...
Why only Janaushadhi? See, Janaushadhi is not needed at all. You take up all generic drugs, whether generic trade or generic brand, should be at one price. You don't need Janaushadhi Kendras. Make one price. Every generic drug, one company cannot have three prices. Generic means, if generic is 100 rupees and generic brand is 1000 rupees, it's a cheating, it's a fraud with the patient. It's a fraud with the patient.
In that case, the generic medicines should be clearly displayed in every chemist shop.
No. I said whether it is a branded generic or generic. Let's not confuse generic with a brand.
Yeah.
We are talking about a company, a molecule of the company should be at the same price, whether they sell it as brand or a trade or a generic. How does it make a difference?
That is when the government will
act. The government will have to act upon it. And at the moment, till the government acts upon, our duty is to choose. Our duty is, like, we need to know the PTR, price to retailer, and guide the patient for a good quality, cheaper medicine.
But how a normal doctor...
That's their duty. See, every doctor is not giving more than 50 drugs.
No, but how will they know the PTR?
PTR is available on the website. It's available on the website. He needs to know that which PTR, if he wants a contact, he can contact us. At IMA, we are compiling the complete PTR file. And with those drugs, their PTR is low.
Because then on today, whatever is available in the...
Therefore, I am saying, doctors need to work hard. If you really want a good patient-doctor relationship, you want to be health-friendly, then you need to know which cheaper medicine you can take care of the patient. Choose NLEM, don't choose non-NLEM.
We need to differentiate between PTR and MRP.
Yes, people are only understanding the word MRP. They need to understand what is PTR, yes.
So, but how can we convince a pharmaceutical company that we should...
You don't have to. We don't have to. The drugs are available. The drugs are available. See, we have to identify as on today. Say, suppose in your practice, how many drugs you are writing? Guma Ferrari sell 50? Very rarely you will go cross 51st. I don't think so that you will cross more than 25. If you are crossing only those 50 drugs, okay, why do I have to choose food with so many brands? I only have to do a 1 week's analysis to find out which is the cheapest brand available in the market. And like that. That is my job. My job is to help the patient. Suppose I find that a drug is available in the market. Suppose meropenem. I am writing meropenem. It is available at 600 rupees. It is also available as 2800 rupees. Then it is my duty not to buy.
Some brands are available like generic type.
No, I am not talking. I am talking about a good company. I am not talking about a local company. I am talking about, say, for example, I talk about Cipla. So I define that I will not write, I will only choose drugs from these 10 companies. Okay, then I find out that Cipla also makes this drug at 10 rupees, also makes this drug at 20 rupees. So I choose a 10 rupee one.
But how can we make sure that patient is getting that cheaper one?
My job is to write. My job is my prescription. My prescription has to be the cheapest medicine, affordable medicine to that patient. If the patient is taking something else, that means he can afford. I am giving him the affordable care. Na? If a patient can afford, let him go as an imported medicine, let him buy a Mercedes. But my job is to give him the treatment. Say for example, now IMA is doing a study where Dr. Prachi is now helping me out. And the study is that we are trying to come back with, say, treatment of hypertension. If a person can afford only, say, 50 rupees, how do I treat? If a patient can afford 300 rupees a month, how do I treat? So which are the medicines should I choose? Say for example, if the patient says he can afford only 50 rupees a month, I will only give him amlodipine. Amlodipine is costing 80 paisa, so 24 rupees a month. Okay, so that's fine. So with 24 rupees a month, the whole blood pressure treatment is there. Suppose I find a patient with hypertension and diabetes, then I need to choose, okay, how can I give him a treatment in 150 rupees? Then I must know that in 150 rupees, that which medicine to buy from where? So I would say, okay, you can buy this medicine from Jan Aushadhi. That will reduce your cost. So this is how I need to work. So I need to come back with a package for the patient. That is monthly outgo should not be more than that. And that's what social medicine is. These are called social determinants of health. The new concept is that my duty is to take away the social determinants to see his economic health status. Will he take the medicines or not? If I am going to give him a medicine for 700-800 rupees, he will take a 1 month, 2 month, 3 month, he will stop. Then he will go back to Ayurveda. Then he will go back and say, but if I know, suppose I ask him what is your income, he says my income is 10,000 rupees. Okay, 10% of 10,000, 1,000 rupees on medical treatment, I cannot. If in a month, 10% of his salary goes on medical treatment, or 1%, and 3% are sick, he is sold. So we are now calculating what should be the percentage on health, which I feel it should not be more than 5%.
Yeah,
for the family. The 5% of your total income should not be, you should not spend more than 5%. So therefore those people where their total income is available is 500, they should not be able to afford private sector. So they should go for Mohalla clinics. These are the people who should go for Mohalla clinics. And their medicines, out-of-pocket medicine should not cost them more than 500 rupees for the family. So I should not write them vitamins. I should not write them cough syrup which are not needed. Kyun cough syrup likhna? Shahad aur agar aapko paani lo na. Why should we write costly medicines to them? So this concept called social determinants of health. How do I treat a patient where he can be fine? If a person is rich, fine. If a person is rich, fine. But then those people who can't afford, we need to decide their monthly family income, 5%, and then try to see how can I give him treatment with that 5%.
Certain people should be encouraged to use the government facilities.
No, when I say why only government? Dispensaries, Mohalla clinics, government to private sector, charitable institutions. But this shouldn't happen that they're going to charity, not paying for a consultation, but the medicines return are 1,000 rupees a month. So social determinants of health means that a patient is going to which atmosphere, I do consider his year monthly income and pay him and give him medicines according to that. So let me take again an example of hypertension. Losartan, 150. 2 tablets morning evening, 2 rupees. Total equal 60 rupees. Okay, amlodipine, say 1 rupee. So I can give him amlodipine, 30 rupees. Suppose he is not controlled, then I can add losartan. And now combination of ACE inhibitor, AR blocker and calcium channel blocker is recognized as one of the best combination. So total mila ke 100 rupees. So I should be able to manage in 100 rupees. If not, if I want to give a beta blocker, I give him a combination of amlodipine and atenolol, which is 1 rupee, hardly 30 rupees. So in less than 100 rupees, I should be able to manage 90% of hypertensives. So 90% of hypertensive I should be able to manage in 100 rupees. But those who can afford, yes, I have Esinsartan, 20 rupees, 600 rupees medicine. Okay? With Esinsartan, then we will, if I am writing a 600 rupees medicine, then my fees will also be 1000 rupees, let them pay 2000, 3000 rupees a month. But for a person who says my expenditure is 100 rupees on medicine, then he should expenditure should be say 200 rupees a month, 100 rupees on medicine, 100 rupees on doctor. So he says my budget is 200 rupees, 100 rupees on medicine, 100 rupees on doctor. Investigations are included. So that way we have to create. Say for example, I'll give you an example that when we used to do investigations, how do we used to do it? We used to do the chemical smear ourselves. Cost zero. Okay, we used to see it ourselves. Peripheral smear will tell you low platelet count, it will tell you TLC, it will tell you anemia, it will tell you leukemia, it will tell you hemolysis. Okay, then we used to do ESR, zero cost, whether there is infection or no infection. And then we used to do a urine examination microscopy. Okay, urine albumin protein 1 rupee strip, and then microscopy cost zero. So my effort is there, but in 1 rupee, I have been able to get most of the diagnosis. So I should be able to get 90% of my diagnosis is available to me at a disposable cost of 1 rupee to me as a doctor. I can charge any amount, what I want, depending upon the patient. If a patient is total budget is 50 rupees, I should do it free. But if I send it to a lab, he is sold. So therefore, point of care investigations have to come with the doctor. So we need to talk about social determinants of health, that those people who say, I cannot afford more than 100 rupees a month, then it is my duty to look after him within that range.
But the days of doing investigations by the doctors, there are no
doctors. They have to come back. They have to come back. I am only trying to say they have to come back. Days are over, they have to come back. Or they should go to government sector. These are the people who should go to government. Why should we go to government sector? People who can afford should not go to government sector then. These are the people who should go to the government sector.
Yes, they can be the government.
But there will be people, so therefore what's the idea of a person who can't afford and then shouting that Apollo did this, Max did this, Fortis did this. If you're going to a 5-star hospital, you should be prepared to pay 5-star charges. You can't expect to a 5-star hotel and say, mere ko 10 rupees ki roti de do. It's not possible. So those hospitals are in need of a day, they're fine. But you can't expect them to do charity. So they are not made for charity. So there has to be a concept of a budget hospital. Budget hospital is, you break even with middle class, you subsidize the poor class, and you earn from the high class. That's the concept. So middle class and lower class should make you even as your project even should come. No profit, no loss should be at a middle class level, at a semi-private level. And private wards should give you the profits.
But we do have some of the budget hospitals run by the charitable
hospitals. Give me an example.
Yes.
These are missionary hospitals. Holy Family and St. Stephen's. They still are above middle class. They still are our middle class. I'm talking about more lower than them. But they do have general ward, they do have semi-paid, but there has to be a transparency. My idea of transparency is there should not be a differential billing. There should be only one billing. That is 100 rupees. Then he says, if you are admitted here, you will be charged 75 rupees. If you are a general ward, you will be charged 50 rupees.
Okay.
for the same treatment. But what happens today is, say, I'll give you an example of a corporate hospital. They will admit you with a saying that you are, we are giving you a room of 500 rupees. But investigations are 100 rupees. Doctor's fees is less, but investigation and medicines are 500 rupees. You are sold. What's the idea? If you are reducing your, in a bill of 1 lakh, you are saying I'm reducing the room rent. For a 5 days, you have reduced 5,000 rupees, but 95,000 rupees you are charging. So you are charging on the disguise of a room rent discount, but you are recovering that cost in other things. No. Economy ward means total bill 50%. That means in an economy ward, your medicines have to be given at 50%. Because that's your margin. Your margin is more than 50%.
But you are telling that we should have a differential rates.
Certainly. This is differential, right? 50%, 75%, 100%. Okay. Total bill is 800 rupees. Okay. You charge 75%, 95% discount.
Okay.
For general ward, is it 50% discount? Or you can come back is that, see, for general ward, you can say PTR plus 10% for investigations and devices.
But how to assess that person, whether he fits through that higher category or lower?
How does it matter? How does it matter? As long as he is ready to share, see, can I restrict you from choosing a 5-star hotel or a dharmshala? It's your choice. You may be a crorepati, and if you are willing to go and share a general ward, a general Barsati in a village. Suppose you say to me, Bombay mein jaunga, wahan pe main jaake dharmshala mein rahunga. Who stops you? This is sharing facility. It had nothing to do with richness.
But he is eating away the your income also.
No. Why is he eating? He is getting discount because he is sharing. Or in one room.
But your consultation is also ready.
Doesn't matter, but there are four patients in that room. See, that room, see, this is a patient, one patient, and six patients. So in six patients, I'm getting six consultations. That is much more than a person who's there in the room.
That is for the admitted patients.
Hmm?
But the person, suppose I am well-to-do person, so you will have to charge me about 500 rupees for consultation. But I come in a disguise of a poor patient.
Hmm.
And you are charging me only 100 rupees.
No matter. But then when you go back to the hospital, you will be admitted to general ward.
Okay.
But under my care.
Yes.
So this is the doctor. You can cheat me once, but not a hundred. So let's not go into that. Cheaters are less than 5%. So Gopal Dutt has, what are some affordable drugs? All drugs which are national list of essential medicines are affordable drugs. So, and all drugs in Jan Aushadhi are affordable drugs. Gauri Shankar Maurya, from where can I get more information about affordable treatment? Go on listening to our series of affordable treatment, which will continue. And if you have a specific problem, talk to us. Jiska koi nahi uska ye main. Dr. Rajneesh Gupta, sadly, these important aspects of patient care are never taught to students in medical college. Rajneesh ji, we are now creating awareness. We have made all medical students as a free membership of Indian Medical Association, and we are trying to sensitize them on affordable care. The very fact Indian Medical Association has taken this topic, it means we mean business and we mean affordable health care to the community. Dr. Rajneesh Gupta again, patients' inclusion in selection of drugs as per his financial status is very important. Yes, that is called social determinants of health. When a patient is going back, treat the patient not in the setting of the hospital, but think in the setting where he is going to go back. Talk about his availability. You can't tell a patient to buy a mask when he can't afford it. You can't tell a patient to buy costly drugs when he can't afford it. So prevention, primordial prevention, and treatment according to his reach is the answer. A patient is not going to take treatment if he is going to sell his house. No way. He is going to miss the treatment. And all those treatments which are available free. So Hep C treatment is available free. TB treatment is available free. HIV treatment is available free. It is criminal on our part to treat a patient with tuberculosis. And if he cannot afford, why not refer him to a nearest TB center and get him totally treated free of cost? Similarly, all those investigations, say for example, dengue, malaria, chikungunya, flu, all these investigations are available free of cost in more than 9 centers in the city of Delhi. Even if you are going to a private doctor, fine, you can give him consultation, but he should refer you to these centers where the investigations are free. So there is no reason for you that therefore the concept of social determinants of health is extremely important. Treat the patient in the atmosphere where he is living and where he is going to go back, and not with your level of perception. Anything, Dr. Prachi, you want to add?
So I just want to add one thing. Like, there is no, nowadays there is no concept of insulin for diabetic patients in the government sector. They are relying only on the OHS. If a patient is insulin dependent,
my unfortunate thing is that we need to understand that heparin versus low molecular weight heparin. That if an economically weaker section of the society, heparin may be as good as low molecular weight. The cost may be 1,000 versus 100 rupees. Similarly, the simpler insulin may be very cheap, but the human insulin may be very costly. So therefore, when it comes to the government sector, because people are now more and more of writing human insulin, which is costly, an ordinary patient may not be able to afford. We must go back to simpler treatment, first line treatment as much as possible for people who can't afford. So therefore, my idea is, ask the patient how much he can afford and tailor-made his treatment plan. Suppose a patient says, I cannot afford more than 300 rupees a month, and where you as a doctor will say, okay, 100 rupees is mine, 50 rupees are for investigations, 150 rupees are for medicines, he says, come back tomorrow. Now plan his program in such a way that he gets a treatment in 300 rupees. That is missing, and that's what the real medicine is, and that's what social determinants of health are. You can't go back and tell him, take this, take this, take this, and take this. If you really want to practice social medicine, we need to understand the social status of the patient. If a patient says, my budget is 2,000 rupees a month, fine, plan accordingly. But if a patient says, my budget is 300 rupees a month, plan accordingly. Never, 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 never let the patient sell his earnings and do everything in that particular condition. Now, we have Anand Raman Tiwari. So please tell why MRs are allowed even to enter government hospitals. Why don't they restrict in their business only in private sector? No, even today, as on today, till the government makes a mechanism to treat the doctors, doctor and pharma relationship is a sacred relationship. We are dependent on them to acquire new knowledge about new molecules, which there is no other way to know them. But everybody should not think that there is a nexus between a doctor and an MR. Anand Raman Tiwari again, sir, please tell, the same question he has asked twice. So I don't think so, we should, if a doctor is standing with a chemist, doesn't mean he has come to take his hafta. If a doctor is talking to MR, doesn't mean that he is getting some gifts from the MR. There is always a sacred relationship between doctor and a nurse, doctor and a pharmacy, doctor and a chemist, doctor and a MR relationship. Anything else, Dr. Mahathir?
No, there was one question, one person was asking where they can get the affordable treatment. So if they know, if they can tell the city, name of the place and the disease.
Yes, we should be able to.
We will be able to help them.
Say, for example, there can be a trust hospital in the city, which is, so you ask for a society hospital, trust hospital, private hospital, and private hospital will always be costly, but in trust hospital you may get a cheaper treatment, and there will be the government hospital and doctor-owned nursing homes. Usually they are compassionate, usually they are considerate, and they may be able to give you considerable discounts. One more question has come is, he's just thanking a lot, sir. It's half an hour, and so again let me revise that the job of a doctor is affordable healthcare. Those people who can't afford, they still can be helped by going to government sector. If the government sector is not being able to provide them treatment, they can apply through the counselor or the MP or the MLA to Prime Minister Relief Fund. There are funds available in the government side as the Delhi Kalyan Samiti and Delhi Arogya Niti and Delhi Arogya Samiti. Similarly, there are schemes in every state. There are different schemes for every state for patients with economically weaker section or patients who cannot afford the BPL patients. Then you can go to the trust hospitals where they are affordable healthcare. But the best is to talk to your general doctor. Ask your doctor, where do I go? If you are not happy with your doctor, go back to him again. The purpose is never go back to a different doctor. If you feel that you are upset with your doctor, if you are not getting the answer with your doctor, for a grievance, go back to the same doctor again and again till he gives you the right answer. Remember, medical profession was noble, is noble, will remain noble, and let's don't understand the social determinants of health.
More questions?
Some more questions have come. There is a question by Kuldeep. Question is not coming. Just hold on. Can you read out the question?
Pardon?
Can you open the question to me? In the meantime, Dr. Prachi, this concept of spending time with a patient is only first time. So therefore, I feel that every doctor should have a counselor, should have a pharmacist, should have a receptionist. The cost of that, the counselor should be able to give bad counseling, this counseling, and that counseling. And the pharmacist should be able to, and the counselor should also be able to decide the financial status and the standards of his living. So the black spot in noble profession, they're giving some examples of black spot of noble profession. This is Kuldeep Aggarwal. He's talking about that there is a loot kingdom in many hospitals. Kuldeep ji, we are talking about the medical profession. We are not talking about particular instances. You will always find, there will always be dissatisfied people. But remember that for every 99, one dissatisfied people, there are 999 satisfied people also. Let's respect them. If you feel a particular incidence, if you are quoting, and if you feel that a particular example has come as a distress, go back to the same hospital, and if they can't satisfy, people like us are still there to look into it and take up the cause for the interest of the society. Let's not defame the medical profession. Yes, I am lobbying for doctors, patients kept aside. IMA is lobbying only for doctors. No, that's not correct. We are lobbying for the patients. Remember, no doctor is incomplete without the patients. Unless we take care of the patients, we have no existence. Doctors have no existence without the patients. And I just gave an interview on the word of Lavaris. Some journalist came and he said, "Ek hospital mein Lavaris patient ko lekar aaye." I said, "There is nothing like Lavaris. When the patient comes to the doctor, he is no more a Lavaris. Doctor is for him." And we are talking about majority of the doctors. And if some doctors are doing a bad thing, expose them. But let's talk about his medical profession. Was noble, is born noble, and will remain noble. Anand Raman Tiwari, yes sir, please tell me efficacy of generic drugs. All drugs have same quality. Any drugs which have been passed by the regulator, also they are absolutely of the same quality. Tell us about drug inspection and regulation of generic medicine. Why CDSO doesn't take inspection seriously? No, they are taking our inspection seriously, but health is a state matter. States also has a responsibility. Let's go back. One thing we come back ultimately is have faith in your family doctor. Find out a family doctor, put him on a retainership. It is always better to put your doctor on a retainership. Some amount of money is given to him on a monthly basis to look after your interests. That's one of the best answers which can be done. Doctors work as sales representative of medical companies. If somebody is working as a sales representative of medical companies, that's unethical. We don't support it. But most of the doctors would not. Nobody will work as a sales representative because doctors are much above a company. I don't think so. Doctors are made to earn money that way. There is enough opportunity for doctors because there is no shortage of patients. And I personally feel doctors should work for wellness and not for sickness, because you will then get 90% of the market which are not sick. So your basically money should come from patients by not making them sick, by becoming the family doctor of a company on a retainership basis. Suppose I have 500 or 1000 companies as my retainership basis and I don't make them sick, that's my doctrine, and not to make them sick and then earn money with that. And why JAS stores only in civil hospitals? JAS stores only in civil hospitals of India. Janoshi stores? No, IMA has a store. There are hospitals. Even you can open. Even you, Anand, even you, if you want, you can apply for it. We'll help you out in getting open. Anybody can open a Janaushadhi Kendra. So it is not required that Janaushadhi Kendra has to be in the government sector. So that's all for today. Let's have the final word from Dr. Prachi and by Dr. Kam. Dr. Prachi.
All the patients has to have a faith in one doctor who is taking care of their primary health, and it is a basic concept of a primary general health physician which has to be revived back.
Okay, Dr. Kamath.
This is the one of the initiative of IMA and Dr. K.K. Aggarwal for the benefit of the patients and how the patients can be directly benefited at a low cost treatment without unnecessarily spending that hard and money. And this shows we will be continuing every week, and we will be meeting again next week until that time. So have a good day. Thank you, Dr. K.K. Aggarwal and Dr. Prakash.
Thank you, and see you next week, Thursday, with another topic. Thank you.